It's actually weird how two people can be so different from each other, yet so intertwined with each other. How two careers can be near proof negative of each other and yet ultimately lead to some crossroads of sorts. This video that started off as a complete telling of their alleged rifts. But in research, I found a story so complex that makes me actually ask, can there be such a thing as fate? So let's start with this picture of India winning the 2011 World Cup. Did you notice something weird? You have Virat, Dhoni, Ashwin and Raina here. Names that would become the mainstay of the Indian team for the next few years to come. All of them except Rohit Sharma. Now, this gets even more weird when you check the 2007 T20 World Cup lineup. Rohit Sharma and Dhoni are front and center. But none of the other names are to be found. Weird, ain't it? Well, the explanation starts about 4 months before this picture was taken. 2007 ODI World Cup ends with India's group stage exit and nearly all of the seniors together forgo playing in the upcoming T20 World Cup. BCCI, in a near panic, starts trying out new players to fill up the spot, one of whom is Rohit Sharma. A well-known name in domestic circuits, and he proved the validity of his name on his debut against Ireland. Not only did he get selected for the T20 World Cup, but he was then invited to play in the Commonwealth Bank Series in Australia, where a young Rohit tacked up 235 runs, including a match-winning partnership with Sachin. So, it was no shock when in the inaugural IPL season, he was quickly picked up by the Deccan Chargers for a whopping $750,000. That's for a newcomer, mind you. But in the same auction, there was another newcomer who was 2 years younger than Rohit, who had recently won the Under-19 World Cup for India. And he was bought by Royal Challengers Bangalore for a measly $30,000. A 19-year-old Virat Kohli. Don't feel too bad about that price tag though. Within months of the auction, due to an injured Sehwag and Sachin, that 19-year-old Virat, with just 8 List A matches under his belt, was called into the Indian team, where he posted a half century in his 4th match. For a youngster, not only was his overall performance laudable, but it at least warranted him continuing till Sehwag and Sachin returns. But as surprisingly as he was selected, he was dropped. Rumors were he had the skills, but the attitude needed work. When he was still not taken into the team after scoring 500s in 7 domestic ODIs, the message was loud and clear. Fix your attitude. Later, Virat went on to say, as a youngster coming into the team, thinking that you are part of the group just because they are being nice to you, and then saying anything to them at any point of time was wrong on my part. You need to know your limitations and you need to learn from them. Well, on the other hand, Rohit, after the initial flying start, with predictions and prophecies of having the right attitude to become the next Sachin Tendulkar, he had begun his pendulum tour. You know, pendulum. From this end to that. From a glorious start to an abject failure. Series after series after series, he failed to perform. And finally, he was replaced by Suresh Raina and put on reserve. Virat, on the other hand, after being dropped, seemed to have taken it personally. In an interview taken in 2013, he said, "For 1.5 years straight, I was just spending time working in the gym or in the field practicing. I didn't feel like hanging out with friends or going out to party even once. I just wanted to train." And it showed. He went ham on domestic circuits. He was given a chance to play in the Indian Board President's 11 versus Australia in a practice match. Where Virat, against a bowling lineup of Brett Lee, Stuart Clarke, Mitchell Johnson, Peter Sittle and Jason Kreza, made a century. The Australians were so impressed or irritated by this that they asked the BCCI to send him to the 2009 Emerging Players Tournament to be held in Australia, where Virat scored 398 runs at an average of 66.33. Kohli would later go on to say that this tournament was the turning point of his career. And turning point it was. Because soon, he was called into the team as a reserve player. Replacing? Yeah, Rohit Sharma. Till this point, wherein Rohit seemed to have wasted his chances, Virat, on each and every chance he got to play, proved his mettle. from an unbeaten 79 in a single ODI against West Indies to a half century against Sri Lanka. And finally, a century in a 224-run partnership along with Gautam Gambhir. In this match, the man of the match was awarded to Gambhir, who refused to take it and asked it to be given to Virat Kohli instead. And still, in spite of all of that, his position was not secure. Raina was in close contention for that number 4 spot. And Rohit Sharma had made a statement by scoring triple century in a Ranji Trophy match. So, all three of them were selected for the 2009 Tri-Nations Tournament. Unofficially, this was to be the tournament where the number 4 position would be finalized. And Virat Kohli destroyed his competition. He finished as the leading scorer with 275 runs with an average of 91.66. Yes, 91.66. The newspaper that day said that Virat Kohli had initially threatened to go the Rohit Sharma way, but his innings in Mirpur today has signalled his journey to maturity. The victor had been decided and awarded. In the upcoming Zimbabwe tour, in the absence of Dhoni and all other seniors, the vice captaincy was given to Kohli. Well, what was Rohit doing, you ask? After having a mostly lackluster Tri-Nation tour, it was under the vice captaincy of Kohli that Rohit scored his first ODI 100 and the second one right after that. Even Raina had found his form by the end of this tour, if nothing else. At least we seem to have found a good lineup for the upcoming World Cup. Right? Yeah. It was like all three of them suddenly at once decided to forget how to play cricket after that. Just look at the stats of these players in the run-up of the World Cup. What in the world is this? At least in Virat's case, he seemed to have woken up after 2 failed series. But for Raina and Rohit, the upcoming South Africa tour was to be a do-or-die tour, where one did, and the other, not only did he die, but after dying, he was further buried and cremated. So, right before the World Cup, Rohit Sharma was dropped from the ODI squad. And hence we get this, with Virat winning a World Cup and Rohit nowhere in the picture. Well, if you're feeling bad for Rohit, just hold on to it for a minute because things are about to get worse. A lot worse. Just after the World Cup, with Yuvraj Singh being unwell, Rohit was recalled into the team for the West Indies tour, where he roared back to form being the lead scorer. He seemed to have carried the same form in the tour to England, where in the first match, he was injured. When he returned, he was to be given a chance to play in the practice test match for the Australia tour, with a chance to make his test debut, a chance that was destroyed by a century from Kohli. And after that, all traces of any sort of form had been scrubbed off of Rohit. In the year 2012, he scored a grand total of 169 runs at an average of 13. The fact that he wasn't booted off the team was only and only because, for some godforsaken reason, Dhoni seemed to believe in him. The same belief Dhoni had shown in keeping Virat in the team when selectors were calling for his head after the initial failure in the 2012 Australian tour. The same tour where he was selected over Rohit and was to be replaced by him. The belief that resulted in Virat scoring 1026 runs in ODI and 689 runs in Test in 2012. The same belief that had nominated Virat Kohli to be named as the vice captain of the Indian team, ahead of both Raina and Gambhir. And the same belief that in the 2013 Champions Trophy had made Rohit Sharma open for the team. What followed was nothing short of a miracle. That Rohit, that couldn't seem to even middle football if he tried, went on to become the 4th highest scorer in this tournament. 4 spots below the first ranked Shikhar Dhawan, and with a difference of just 1 run, just above Virat Kohli. The bearers of India's future had found their form. Virat Kohli was being moulded into the future captain, and the competition for being a regular in the team was done for now. And forget about having any bad feelings between them. Virat Kohli, in response to a question, who are the future leaders in the team, had famously went on to say that Rohit has tremendous cricketing brains. I often take his advice during matches. This was Rohit and Virat at their closest. But things, as in life, were about to change. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll cover the rest of the story in my next video, and I hope you all give it a try. Till then, thank you for watching.